Hello friends, in the last class we have completed very small topics which are there in stomach. So in this topic I would like to deal with ulcer. You know, ulcers, gastric ulcer, urinary ulcer, basically ulcer topic consists of acute ulcers, which are acute peptic ulcer, which may be gastric ulcer or urinary ulcer, and then chronic ulcers, which may be gastric ulcer and urinary ulcer again, and then we'll have to deal with the complications of ulcers and perforation of gastric and urinary ulcers, and then we'll have to deal with the recurrent ulcers and also the complications of gastrojejunostomy and many other things which are continuously, which should be watched continuously, so that you will understand or you will get a grip on ulcers. You know, ulcers are majorly the most important topic in the ulcers are very important in surgery, because most of the topics in stomach are completely confined of ulcers. Other than the gastric carcinoma, and also all the other topics which were unrelated to ulcers are already dealt in one lecture. So in this lecture, I would like to complete the whole ulcer topic. If it's not possible, I would do one more lecture to complete the topic on ulcer. Right? So first, let us learn about the acute peptic ulcer. So in acute peptic ulcer, peptic ulcers can be acute or chronic. This acute peptic ulcer can either be urinary ulcer or gastric ulcers. So what are the major causes of acute peptic ulcer? The major causes of acute peptic ulcer include stress, then drugs like analgesics and steroids, and also surgeries. These are the major causes of acute peptic ulcer. So what are the clinical features that will be dealt with acute peptic ulcer? Number one, in acute peptic ulcer, the patient presents with pain in the epigastric region. Here there'll be pain. So pain in epigastric region. Sometimes tenderness is also felt. There may be vomiting with or without plus or minus hematemesis. Right? And then the most important, two major important things why acute peptic ulcer occur is in cerebral trauma. After cerebral trauma or after surgeries, that to neurosurgeries, when we get peptic ulcers, those are called as Cushing's ulcers. If ulcers are formed after burns, they are called as Curling's ulcers. And how do you diagnose them? The best diagnosis is by gastroscopy. And now, what is the treatment of acute peptic ulcer? The treatment of acute peptic ulcer is IV ranitidine, which is given 50 mg 8 hourly. And then do IV fluids. Give IV fluids, and also blood transfusions are given. Most of the time, surgery is not required for acute ulcers. So patients are always advised to take anti-ulcer drugs for 4 to 6 weeks. 4 to 6 weeks, like ranitidine, omeprazole, lansoprazole. What are the other types of ulcers? Curdling ulcers are the ulcers due to burns, as I have said, and these present as pain in the major epigastric region with vomiting and hematemesis, as we have already seen how acute gastric ulcer presents. So now the treatment is conservative, in that we give IV ranitidine or pantoprazole. Okay, so this is about curdling ulcers. Cushing's ulcers, it occurs after cerebral trauma. Or after neurosurgeries. The best thing is IV ranitidine. So this is about acute peptic ulcer. Now coming to the chronic peptic ulcers which are seen. Chronic peptic ulcers can be again duodenal ulcer or gastric ulcer. As you all know, I'm combining both surgery and medicine as one topic, because whatever we deal with in the medicine, the same will be dealt in surgery, right? The only difference is there is surgical treatment. All the other topics will not generally change. So here I would like to discuss combining both surgery and medicine as a whole in this topic, right? So first let us learn the whole pathogenesis of chronic peptic ulcers which are seen, and after learning about the pathogenesis, now let us learn the pathogenesis of the peptic ulcer disease as a whole, right? So peptic ulcer disease, in medicine or in surgery, the major pathogenesis, the major reason for peptic ulcer disease is there are two different, the pathological conditions, the pathological mechanisms why duodenal ulcer occurs and why peptic ulcer, gastric ulcer occurs. If you see, first gastric ulcer. In gastric ulcer, the first major etiological, pathological mechanism is disruption in mucosal barriers. Because disruption in mucosal barriers, the mucosa has some barriers. So whenever there is disruption of this mucosal barriers, then there is increased acid levels in the stomach, which causes gastric ulcers. Whereas in the duodenum, if you see, in duodenum there is no acid production. But why are there duodenal ulcers? That is important for you to learn why there is duodenal ulcer. It's not due to increased acid production. Here, if you see, in gastric ulcers there is increased acid production in the stomach. So gastric acid is more. So if you measure average basal and nocturnal gastric acid secretion increases. Average basal and nocturnal gastric acid secretion is increases here, and bicarbonate secretion decreases. So this is what generally happens here. But what does it happen in duodenal ulcers? In duodenal ulcers, the gastric acid output is generally normal. Okay, the gastric output, acid output is generally normal. But here, why is there Oh.